and welcome to another exciting day on the Word of Resurrection. We're excited about resurrection because it's God's affront against Satan and every demonic power and every demonic success in your life. Resurrection answers death. Resurrection answers brokenness. Resurrection answers the years you have lost. Because when God resurrects you, you will be on your way to a tremendous victory. The glory of God remaps our lives and recaptures lost time. It is a message that can never be overemphasized. I didn't say it will be easy. I didn't say you will not feel pain. I'm just telling you that God is faithful. And may I invite you once again to join us at the steps of the Georgia State Capitol, where we'll be meeting with the Lord to pray for our nation, our city, and our state, and all that God has laid on our hearts to do. And then if you're in the Atlanta area, we encourage you to join us for the parade the very next day. The parade starts at noon. We want the world to experience His glory. Come and see believers giving testimonies of what the Lord has done for them. There'll be a hearse saying, "Don't wait for me to take you to church." The story of salvation will be on floats. Hallelujah. Come out, bring out the family. It will be a great time. We are studying Matthew 27, beloved, that after Jesus was killed or murdered on the cross, He was buried. And the Pharisees went to Pilate and said, "This deceiver promised that he will rise from the dead after 3 days." What did we learn yesterday? Whatever happens to Jesus is only an example of what we will go through. Beloved, have they called you a nasty name? They called Jesus a deceiver. Remember that. He said, "This deceiver said that after 3 days, he will rise from the dead." But beloved, I saw something even greater, that they called him a deceiver, and yet they were afraid of his word. I promise you, beloved, Satan is afraid of the word of God. If you hold on to the word of God, it will bring you to great victory. If you hold on to the promises God made you, you will see resurrection power. But don't forget, God allows the enemy to gloat. God allows them to do all that they can do. And then God will show up to show who is God, who has the power, who is the Lord of glory, the Lord strong and mighty. He is the King of glory. And so, according to the text, I don't need to read it, we read it yesterday, Pilate said to them, "Go and make the tomb secure." Go and secure it. And they went, another gospel tells us exactly, they brought Roman soldiers, they put a seal on it, they made it secure to make sure that Jesus will not come out of that grave. They didn't believe what he said. They assumed that the disciples will come and steal him at night. Beloved, tell me this. Have you seen that your enemies and your critics are always trying to discount the miracle of God in your life? They're always trying to explain it away. They're always trying to say it didn't happen. Beloved, miracles still happen. I can't wait. Let me go immediately to chapter 28. The Bible says, "In the end of the Sabbath, as it began to dawn toward the first day of the week, came Mary Magdalene and the other Mary to see the sepulcher. And behold, there was a great earthquake, for the angel of the Lord descended from heaven and came and rolled back the stone from the door and sat on it." Oh, beloved, this is so encouraging. I love it. Years ago, a man of God preached a message. He says, "Man's extremity is God's opportunity." They sealed the tomb with the Roman seal. They had the soldiers guarding it. If you touched it, they will kill you. They would have killed you. But beloved, the Bible says in the end of the Sabbath, when you read the scriptures, don't take it for granted that you understand what it means. Because you see that there is always a Sabbath before the resurrection. There is always a rest that God is calling you and I to before he comes. We learned the first day, let the enemy gloat, let them mock, let them make noise. It's only temporary. The Lord your God is on his way. I know it. I am in it right now. I will prove it to be true because I've proven it over and over and over again. What is the Lord calling you to? Enter into his rest. Release the issue. Release the people. So resurrection will come. There is a season where God wants you to rest and leave the issue with him and leave the people with him and leave the sickness with him and leave the financial issues with him and leave the supervisor with him and leave your child with him. Whatever that's going on, enter by faith into the rest of the Lord. God has a Sabbath season in your life. Resurrection will show up at the end of your Sabbath. Carry it with you this morning. Go to that job. Leave home. Relate to your children. Whatever the issue is, remember that as you enter into the rest of the Lord, resurrection will come knocking on your door. Amen and amen. I will meet you here tomorrow, same time, for you to experience the glory of resurrection. God bless you. We'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye.
Waiting on you. Yes, he is, yes, he is. Yes.